Yes, we can't go for Hajj this year, but there's so many practices that Sahaba radiallahu anhum learned from Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, through which Allah Ta'ala will reward us and give us rewards of Hajj. One is the tasbihat after our salawat, 33 subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. This is one of the virtues. Allah Ta'ala rewards a person for Hajj and so forth. The other is the beautiful report of Tirmidhi. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, he who performs his Fajr salah with Jamaat, and then he sits making dhikrullah until the sun rises, after that he performs 2 rakats of salah, kana lahu mithlu ajri hajjatin wa umrah. Allah rewards him the reward of a full Hajj and Umrah. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam then said, tamma, 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 full Hajj, full Umrah, full Hajj, full Umrah. This is reported by Abu Umama radiallahu anhu. The other is the hadith of Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, he who goes to the masjid to learn something of deen or teach something of deen, Allah rewards him with a Hajj. The other is that in Abu Dawood Sharif, that person who performs wudu at home and then he goes to the masjid, لِأَدَاءِ صَلَاةٍ مَكْتُوبَةٍ, to fulfill his fard salah. Now he made wudu at home and he goes to the masjid, Allah rewards him, and his reward is مِثْلُ أَجْرِ الْحَاجِ الْمُحْرِمِ, like one who's on Hajj and he is in Ihram. And he who specially goes to the masjid to perform his charged salah, duha prayer, Allah rewards him and he is equated to one who is on his way to Umrah. Hassan Basri rahimahullah says, مَشْيُكَ فِي حَاجَةِ أَخِيكَ الْمُسْلِمِ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حَجَّةٍ بَعْدَ حَجَّةٍ, to walk to fulfill another Muslim's need, to walk and fulfill another brother's need, Allah rewards you for that with the rewards of Hajj after Hajj. So there's so many deeds we can perform through which Allah will reward us with the rewards of Hajj. And lot of it also is to help others and serve others and make khidmah of humanity. Let us not judge others. Let us serve others and think good of others. We all conceal our own faults, but certainly we should conceal others' faults more. Allah Ta'ala save us from disgracing others or looking down upon others. As we learn in deen, the worst action is ujb. A person can do lots of deeds, but that action that will nullify all those deeds is pride and arrogance, that I carried out this deed. But the quality Allah loves is when we carry out any good deed, we sit with humility, thanking Allah that, oh Allah, I cannot do anything on my own. You enabled me to carry out this wonderful act of or deed or ibadah or assistance to someone or service to someone. Oh Allah, you enabled me to serve you and help this person. Oh Allah, I thank you for the tawfiq you gave me. That's thanking Allah and attributing to Allah. And then seeking Allah's forgiveness. That, oh Allah, in spite of the fact that you helped me to carry out, but my action does not deserve acceptance. Allah, forgive me for my shortcomings, because I can never fulfill your haqq. Through these two qualities of attributing to Allah, saving ourselves from ujb and pride, and seeking Allah's forgiveness, Allah will enable us to do more and more of good deeds. Allah Ta'ala, give us tawfiq. وصلى الله على النبي الأمي برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.